Hello, it's Dan Bull. I've got some news. I'm going to be releasing a Christmas single and I want it to be as successful as I can make it. But I've always been a DIY artist, so I don't really know much about how to promote a record outside of YouTube and the audience that I've built there. I want to learn the tips and techniques that major label artists and promoters use to make their records a success. So I've enlisted the help of Microsoft, who are going to team me up today with a PR expert from the music industry called Jackie Jones. Jackie knows the right people to talk to, how to talk to them, and she's going to guide me through the stages of a successful record launch. Let's get on the train and go and meet her.
I accidentally locked my cat in here while I was filming.
Off you go.
Right, I'm on the train now, on the way to meet Jackie in Camden. I've got a couple of hours to kill, so I've built a little reading list and I'm going to have a look through that and work out some questions to ask her. This is Camden, which is the home of alternative music and culture in London. Lots of famous musicians came up here and made their name here. Just down here as well is where I did my first gig as a solo artist, and it was terrible.
Mama's Jerk Station. I hope they only sell food.
Right, we are here at the Hawley Arms, which is a famous music venue in Camden, the haunt of Amy Winehouse. And I think this is Jackie over here. Jackie?
Yes. Hey Dan, how are you?
I'm good.
Nice to meet you. You well?
Yeah, I'm good.
Good.
You're going for a chat?
Yeah, let's do it.
Thank you.
Have you got a team of people or is it just you
yourself? It's pretty much just me, but that's what I want to look at doing now is to see if I can maybe get some radio airplay in the next few weeks, some news or magazine coverage, so I can reach a wider audience.
So you kind of coming to me and going, you know, I've got like 3 weeks, how am I going to get the single out? I think you've got the perfect platform.
Yeah.
But it's just something maybe unknown to me because I'm just used to like really forward planning.
Does that mean I'm basically too late to
get
it played?
No, you're not too late. Of course you're not. If you've got a video to accompany this and you put it online, it's reacting really well and getting like millions of views, then the radio stations might sit up and take note.
So it's angled more then as a news story rather than just as another of the singles that's coming up.
I think you're going to, you know, because it's so competitive, especially Christmas.
If I'd waited 1 month to January, then no one cares. It would have been easy.
You've released singles before.
I've released loads. I think I've released 150 singles
now. Oh my
God,
yeah. That's crazy.
One every week I try and do.
One a week.
I'm so used to putting a video on YouTube and then just making it available on iTunes. I don't really do a promotion.
So why have you decided to try and make it this time, this single, different? Just because you want to give it a go for the Christmas campaign?
I want to have a go at that.
Yeah.
It's that simple, really.
Yeah.
I mean, even if it's a complete flop, I don't mind because I just want the experience of trying it as a campaign. I don't have a marketing budget or anything for the moment. I haven't put any, like, I've basically turned up here, you today, and I've got a list of a few questions here that I'm going to ask you, and that's basically it. And I've got the song.
Tip one, work out your story. Find the right angle. Include facts and figures. Give the media everything they need to make their job easy. Lazy gits.
A few years ago, I did a song about Lily Allen when she was in the news. And it ended up getting on Channel 4 News and BBC News. I was interviewed for that.
Yeah.
But that all sort of happened without me planning it.
Right.
They came to me. This time I need to sort of go to them and tell them about it and have a story to present to them.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Russell Howard's show that I work on. I don't know if you're familiar with the show, but...
The Good News.
Yeah, The Good News. Those kind of shows would be great because it's, you know...
Although he'll just take the piss out of it. Yeah, because, I mean, that's another place. MCV is something I haven't even bothered thinking about because I just thought that's for people that are on...
Far away.
Yeah, people on the big major record labels, I wouldn't even know where to start.
I worked at MTV for, I think, nearly 7 years. So there's a playlist team and we all sit there and we literally block out Tuesday afternoon where we watch all of the week's music videos.
What would make a video stand out to you when you were watching it and think, we need to put this on?
I think it's just obviously great, great track. I mean, for me, I'm all about the music, so, or just something original, you know.
Tip two, get your story out there. Be proactive. Don't expect to be discovered. Pick multiple targets, radio, print, online, TV. Make a bloody awesome and original music video.
So is there anything, as well as things I should be doing, as the things that I should avoid before I started focusing entirely with YouTube and everything, I was sending demos out to DJs and record labels. So I sent out dozens and dozens of packages to you know, Radio One and to all these record labels that I liked. I would have been happy even with a rejection from them, but instead I just got totally ignored.
There isn't a specific person going through that has a role of going through the mail. So every week you're probably getting dozens.
And I feel like, I don't know, maybe the life thing would almost, if I did it in the traditional way at least, it would get in the way of my creative process rather than help. But if I were to go down the live route, I really like the idea of making it more of an interactive thing with the audience, mm-hmm. where I can meet them or maybe they can contribute. Because YouTube and the internet is so two-way, it's not just broadcasting, it's mm-hmm. Interactive. Mm-hmm. I'd love to be able to get some kind of live experience together mm-hmm. that reflected that rather than just me standing there performing stuff to people.
Yeah, to people.
Tip three, do things your way. Find your own niche. Try new ideas to see what works and what doesn't. Ask your supporters for their help.
So, Jackie, how would I know who in the industry that I'm supposed to be targeting?
Is there any specific, like, DJs that you're every week without fail you will check tune into that show? And then we should talk about, like, maybe getting a biog written. So put down all your subscribers, how many singles you've put out. And we should also put together a nice little sizzle, like a sizzle reel.
So like
just
a sizzle reel.
So just like a compilation of all your best bits. Think about targeting the relevant producers, because I think rather than sending it to everyone and every radio station, it's not worth it.
Yeah, especially in the time frame we've got. And so I need to be very specific about what I'm going to do.
And also just why you like that particular show.
Tip four, build a press kit. Work out who you're targeting and why. Write a biography. Create a sizzle reel. But don't burn your fingers on it, lol.
Oh, God. Although I want to kind of compete with the mainstream singles and everything, I have to be realistic as well and know that there are limits to what I can do. So I understand that getting radio play quite often, there's people like pluggers that you can hire to go and promote the record.
There are plenty of amazing independent TV and radio and digital pluggers. I could give you a list of pluggers who I think might want to work with you.
Yeah. And I guess I use the same story that we were talking about before would perhaps make them more amenable to being involved in it as well.
Absolutely.
If I explain that I'm not on a label and
I think it is worthwhile because they're obviously the people that have got real specialist contacts and can get, you know, that conversation starting, that foot in the door. It's much easier for somebody else to sell you.
Especially because I've come up completely outside of the music industry as well, so I don't have those connections or that reputation to go on. I've jumped in at the deep end.
You have.
Tip five, get a squad behind you, hashtag squad goals. Use existing contacts to make new ones. Listen to constructive criticism. It doesn't have to be costly. You could swap favours. Yeah, favours.
That sort of leads into my final question, which is, would you say that trying to get signed to a record label for an artist like myself is still a good idea in the current kind of industry climate?
I think for you, I think it's amazing what you've achieved so far, so I think you should be very proud of yourself. I think for you, what I would recommend is a TV plugger, a press publicist, and a radio plugger as well, because having those three key people, it would be great to have someone who's objective to tell you if things aren't so great or if things are amazing, or you should maybe put more focus here because you're so close to it. You
can be blinkered, can't you, and just think.
So I think it'd be great to just get someone to steer the ship a little bit.
Yeah, that's a good idea.
Yeah, right. That's what I would advise.
Well, I'm going to take away some of the ideas that we've talked about today and I'm going to have a go at the press kit like you told me. And what I'll do is check in with you on Skype in a few days and let you know how I'm going, and we'll see what we can do from there.
Okay, brilliant.
Awesome,
Sounds
Jackie.
Sounds great, thank you.
It's been really good to meet you.
Lovely to meet you. Good
luck. Great, thank you.
Well, it looks like I've got a lot of work to do, so I better pry myself away from Fallout 4 and get started. If you can think of an idea for a music video, I need one really quick. Also, be sure to try out Windows 10. It's free to upgrade if you're already on Windows 7 or 8, and you can roll it back if you change your mind. But really, who's going to want to keep Windows 8, honestly? There's a link in the description to get you started. Now, next week, I'm going to be talking to an industry plugger who's going to tell me the best strategies to get noticed and heard in the media. Bye. Love you.